everyone! Welcome back to another episode of Teacher Eyes TV! What comes to your mind when you see or when you hear the word caution? Well, maybe some of you will tell me, Teacher I, it means warning. Or it tells us to be careful or to beware. That is right. When we say caution, it's actually a measure taken in advance in order to prevent something dangerous, unpleasant, or inconvenient from happening. You will see different signs in every place that you will go through. Like when you go to construction sites, you will see there, beware of falling debris. Or when you go to a fast food chain, sometimes you will see there that yellow thing that they place on the floor. It says wet floor. When you go to gasoline stations, you will see there warning signs like switch off your cell phones or mobile phones. These are just some of the cautions that we see anywhere and everywhere when we go out. But don't you know that there are also cautions that we have to think about or observe while we are cooking? That is right. And we call them precautions. For this episode, I will be discussing with you the important precautions that we have to observe while we are cooking so that we can prevent any problem or accidents that will take place in our kitchen. That is right. We have three important precautions that we have to observe while we are cooking. And these are observed in order for us to prevent any accident or any problem that we may encounter while we're working in our own kitchens. What are these three sets of precautions? Well, we have number one, safety precautions. Number two, we have sanitary precautions. And number three, we have work precautions. Let's talk about the first set of precautions. We have the safety precautions. What do we mean by this? Safety precautions are the guidelines that we have to observe in order to prevent any accident in the kitchen. What accidents am I talking about? Well, it can be fire, explosion, electrocution, slipping on the floor, burns, cuts, splattering of cooking oil. All these are just some of these accidents that one may encounter while cooking. That is why some people are actually afraid of, working in the kitchen and cooking because they are afraid that this will happen to them. Now, let's talk about prevention. First on our list would be switch off the gas stove and the gas tank when not in use. The question is why? Well, actually, it's as simple as preventing fire and explosion from happening. Number two, do not leave the food you're cooking unattended. Do not do any other things that will actually catch your attention and that you will forget that you are cooking. Why? Because if you do, that may lead us to having fire. Then we go to number three. Plug and unplug appliances with your hands that are dry. What will happen if you plug and unplug appliances with your wet hands? It might cause electrocution. Now the thing here is, if you see a person already be electrocuted, how can you help that person? Well, there is a way to do that. Give that person something that is not a conductor of heat, like for example, cloth or wood, in order to help that person be removed from that situation. But hey, you have to remember this. Never touch that person being electrocuted. You want to know why? Well, it's because the electric current is much higher at the last person touching the person getting electrocuted. So the only way to solve or help that person is to give him or her something that's not a conductor of heat. So it can be cloth or it can be wood. That's it for that. We go to number four. Never pour water into hot cooking oil when it's already on fire. Well, it's because when you do that, you will make the fire even bigger. What can we do to stop it? Number one, we can actually pour or place sand into it, or maybe a wet cloth, really a wet damp cloth into that, or cover it entirely with a lid, or the fruit and vegetable peelings that you still have on your sink. Because when you do that, it stops or eliminates oxygen in that pan with burning oil. And therefore, when there's no more oxygen, fire dies a natural death. We go to number 5. Maintain clean and dry floor at all times. We don't want to see anybody slipping on the floor, right? So, it is important that we don't have any vegetable or fruit peeling scattered on the floor, or the floor is not wet when, you know, we are working, so that we prevent slipping from happening. We go to number 6. Make sure to use sharp utensils like knives and kitchen scissors properly and with care. Why? Because we don't want to see people getting hurt, having cuts because of this. Now, if you have to walk from one place to another in your kitchen and you're holding your knife, make sure that you are holding the tip of the knife with the handle facing down in order to prevent accident as well. And when you give the knife or the kitchen scissors to another person, you hold the tip of the knife or the scissors and give the handle towards the next person. We go to number 7, and that is, use mittens or pot holders when you're holding hot pans or pots. Question is why? Well, obviously, we don't want burns or paso. That is why, use mittens or pot holders to prevent that. We go to number 8, never place wet ingredients into hot cooking oil. Like for example, no, you will saute onions and garlics, or maybe you will fry chicken or any ingredient. We have to make sure it's not wet because we want to prevent splattering of cooking oil. Then we go to the last one. Place ingredients gently into the pan or into the pot when you're cooking. Well, the question here is why? Well, if you do that and you throw it into the boiling liquid or maybe in a hot cooking oil, there is really a big possibility of it splattering on you. So, you will have burns, it will splatter on you. To prevent that, place it gently into the pan or into the pot while we're cooking. These are the basic safety precautions that we have to observe so that we can prevent accidents in the kitchen. We go to the next one, sanitary precautions. Now, let's discuss the second set of precautions, sanitary precautions. When you talk about sanitary precautions, these are the guidelines that help us to maintain cleanliness of our food and of our kitchen workplace. So, what are the common problems that we experience when, you know, when the person who is cooking is actually not hygienic, or maybe the kitchen is dirty? Well, one of those, food contamination. Another one, maybe insects or other foreign objects that we find in our food. So, how do we prevent all this from happening? Let's talk about the first one. Wash your hands before and after cooking. Well, why is that so? Well, actually, our hands are carriers of bacteria and germs. So, whatever we touch or hold may be sources of bacteria that may cause food contamination. That is why it's very important that our hands are clean before we start cooking. Number 2, trim your fingernails regularly. Our fingernails are also sources and carriers of bacteria. That is why you have to make sure that there are no dirt that may be found in the fingernails. And to avoid that, it's just safe to say that we trim it regularly. That's number 2. We go to number 3. Wash the ingredients before cooking them. Why? Well, they are also carriers of bacteria. Like for example, meat and chicken and fish, they have to be washed well to make sure that there are no more dirt that may be found in them. Now, how do we wash leafy vegetables? If these are leafy vegetables, we have to wash them leaf by leaf so that we are sure that there are no insects or pesticides or any other germs that are still stuck into that. That's number 3. We go to number 4. Wash the utensils before they are used. Before and after using them, actually. Ms. Pacle or Teacher I, even if they're stored in the cabinets? Answer, yes. Because we are not sure of dust and insects that may be found sometimes in our own cabinets. But hey, don't forget, washing your utensils after using them is equally important as washing them before they are used. The question is why? Well, the answer is, if you leave them on the sink dirty and messy, it will invite ants and cockroaches and mice, and we don't like that in the kitchen. That's number 4. We go to number 5. Never use the same spoon for mixing and tasting your food. because we don't want contamination to happen. So how are we going to do that? Get another spoon, place the food that you're tasting from your food turner or ladle into the spoon, and then taste from it. That's number 5. We go to number 6. We have to place the tasting spoon and the mixing spoon on a clean plate as well. You don't leave it on the stove, maybe on the table or on the sink while they are not in use. Then we go to number 7. Remove your wristwatch, your ring, or your bracelet if you have them while you're cooking. Why? It's because they are also carriers of bacteria and germs. That's number 7. We go to number 8. Number 8 is never cough or sneeze right in front of the food that you're cooking. Obviously, we don't want food contamination, and that is why we have to prevent that. We go to number 9. Number 9 is to wear proper kitchen attire. What are actually those that we have to take note of? Number 1, we have to make use of hairnet. Hairnet prevents the hair from falling into the food that we are cooking. Apron is the next one. Apron helps us to prevent our clothes from spilled food or any ingredient while we are cooking. So it prevents us from stains as well. Then we have hand towels. Hand towels that may be used to dry your hands and that may be used also to dry the utensils that you are using while you're cooking. And the last, number 10, maintain the kitchen and yourself clean and neat at all times. I want you to take note of this. A dirty kitchen, a person who is not hygienic, cannot actually come up with clean and nutritious food. That is why it is very important that we maintain our kitchen clean and neat at all times. And if we are cooking, we also make sure that we are clean, we are hygienic, to make sure the food that we are preparing for our family and for our friends are actually safe to eat. These are the sanitary precautions that we have to observe while we are cooking. And we're down to the last set of precautions, and that is work precaution. When you say work precautions, these are the guidelines that help us maintain order in the kitchen and help us to prevent delays while we're cooking. Following these guidelines, we are assured that cooking is efficiently and effectively done in our kitchen. Now, let's talk about these guidelines. First on our list is prepare all the ingredients and utensils before starting to cook. This will actually help us to save time, no? That every ingredient is prepared, they're lined up according to the use that we are to get them for cooking, and the utensils are within our reach so that we don't have to spend so much time looking for them while we are cooking. Then we go to number 2, measure your ingredients accurately. That's a very important work precaution. Why? Because you see, when you measure accurately, it affects the important aspects of the food. Like, what are these? Most importantly, the flavor, then the color, and then the texture, and then the volume or the quantity. So if we don't measure accurately, all these are affected. That is why it is important that before we start cooking, we are measured correctly. That's number 2. We go to number 3. Number 3 is focus on the food that you're cooking. Don't do other things, no, while you're cooking so that you don't get confused of what ingredient has been added already and what has not been added yet. That's number 3. We go to number 4. Number 4, label similar ingredients. What are these? I'll give an example. Flour and cornstarch, they look similar. Iodized salt and refined white sugar, they also look similar. Baking powder and baking soda, they look similar. So, labeling these ingredients will not confuse us of what we have to add to the food that we are cooking. Number 5, we have follow the recipe accurately, especially if it's your first time to cook that certain dish. The question is why? Well, when you do that, you're able to achieve the right color, flavor, texture, consistency, and quality of the food that you're cooking. And, you know, when you just have to make some adjustments with some ingredients, it's easily done because you've already tried doing it following the original recipe. That is number 5. We go to number 6. Number 6, use of appropriate utensil in preparing the food. So meaning if it says use mixing bowl, use a mixing bowl. If it says use a cookie pan, use a cookie pan. By this, we are able to achieve the right quality of the food that we are cooking. So, these are the work precautions that we have to observe while we are cooking in our kitchen to make sure that cooking is made safe, fun, and healthy for all of us. I hope that you learned a lot of things from the video that I shared with you today. And I hope that you will like and share this video to everyone that you know. So then, PLB teachers, home economics teachers, students of this course, and also those who are just starting to learn basics of cooking, please subscribe in my YouTube channel and hit that notification bell for more videos and updates. Once again, this is Ms. Pacle for Teacherize TV. I'll see you again in our next videos. Thank you for watching!